to demand that the war should be devolved up to the lowest level possible where we are, because if we concentrate much on the national government level, we are losing a lot at the county level. We are seeing like what you saw about Waititu. If the governors are Waititus, we are losing a lot of money through corruption at the county level, which we have to combine forces and ensure that every sector where the public funds are invested in, those monies are protected and are put into correct use. Like now, if you walk around, you'll find our people suffering. We don't even have medicine in those stalls, but the money meant for those stalls, we have a right to ask, where is this money going to?
I will be pushing and sponsoring a bill that will seek to amend our criminal justice system in a bid to have all corrupt elements upon a verdict of culpability over them to be hanged, because we are not going to allow a few people to interfere with the dignity, the welfare, and the African decency of our people by swindling the little resources that ought to be helping the Republic of Kenya.
As a country, I am saying that we cannot go on in this manner anymore. Headlines in this country is nothing but corruption. We are looking at figures that you'd call mind-boggling figures that never heard of before, unprecedented figures in this country, on projects that were designed to steal, not to support the people of this country. I, as a member of parliament, I want to bring to parliament and ask parliament to create a department of stalled projects, because there are so many in this country, you begin to wonder, are we in the business of starting projects and leaving them unfinished? We must take stock of all the stalled projects and see how much money is being wasted out there. Kenya as a country, I think we are blessed. And this is the only time, because we have a president who is not seeking re-election. And this is the time that we have to slay the dragon of corruption. This is the only time we have, and it is now or never.
My constituency, there was very buoyant economy. People were going about their business, making their money and enjoying their livelihood. Now, unfortunately, this their dream has been crippled by merchants of corruption, people who run around with impunity. They can carelessly authorize the import of sugar at the altar of leaving the locally, milled sugar, and the farmers to be poor and be impoverished, and they know themselves. So we are praying that with the Building Bridges initiative, we are going to restore the dignity of this country, and we will have order restored to this country, where Kenyans will be equal, and those who think they are seeking office for the purpose of generating more wealth to them, their efforts and dreams will be curtailed, and Kenyans can go and enjoy their wealth. I told you that until the other day, we were employing people from all over the country. People from Nyateke, from this constituency, were coming to Muroni to be employed as loaders, packers, and all those manual workers. Now, unfortunately, some of my constituents are greeting me here. They are now cobblers, they are bicycle repairers, because of our economy that has been ruined by some useless people who think they're the only people who have stomachs, who must amass as much wealth as they want. Thank you very much. We are behind President Uhuru Kenyatta and Raila Amolo Odinga in fighting corruption, and we will continue doing it, whether they want it or not.